Today's video is a bit different. It's a travelogue. I've visited RMC The Cave in England with a friend of mine and thought, why not share the trip with you guys? I think we had planned the trip for over a year now, but finally we were able to do it. So I drove over to Munich Airport and from there we took the plane to Heathrow Airport in London. A casual 90 minutes later we arrived in beautiful sunshine, only to wait for another 60 minutes at the rental office desk. No idea what went wrong there, but well, we got our car and we were back on the road. Our tour from there would take us to Bath, where we booked our hotel. The plan was to explore the city and drive to the Cave the next day. On the way back to the airport, we had two stops. First at Diddley's Quad Farm, if you know Jeremy Clarkson, you might have heard of it, and in Oxford for a quick meal before driving back to the airport. An uneventful highway drive and a cheese-filled pastry later, we finally arrived in the countryside. It was a really nice drive through the rolling green hills and small towns with their stone cottages. What was not that nice were the many deep potholes that required careful maneuvering. After about 2 hours of driving, we arrived at a destination in Bath and checked in the hotel. It was your box standard Holiday Inn, so I totally forgot to take any pictures from that. But we just left the car and took a stroll into the town center. Bath is a really beautiful city. We didn't do any reading before our visit, so we were just wandering through the streets looking at everything, and I think that was probably even a good way to take it all in. During the evening we had lunch with a really nice view and somewhat mediocre food, but we were hungry and it was okay, so that's fine. The next day, the main event. We were on our way to the Cave. Already a sight to behold from the outside, let's not waste any more time and go right in. I mean, I've seen the Cave on many occasions on YouTube before, but it's something completely different to really walk these halls. You just want to go everywhere immediately and take it all in at once, which is obviously impossible. So without any plan of action, we were just stumbling from showcase to showcase, pointing at things like excited kids that were allowed to stay up late and eat candy. But the greatest thing about the Cave is not the collection, but that you are able to play so many games yourself. There are all these old and sometimes rare devices just waiting for you to come over, pick up the gamepad and start to play. And yes, there was obviously a lot of nostalgia involved, as they also had some DOS machines. And I could even take a look at the recently restored Packard Bell, which is close to my heart because my mother used to own one of these and I played on it all the time. We've stayed the whole day and we could have stayed a lot longer. We just took a short break for some English bakery goodness and then it was time to head back to the hotel again. As we were already heading in that direction on our way back, we made a stop at Tetbury, where the UK Microprose offices were located. Yes, they were in this very same shop. If you've enjoyed the video so far and don't want to miss out any future retro gaming goodness, then subscribe to the channel and hit the bell.
This aging man makes a living from driving fast and shouting random nonsense.
Sideways in linen!
He also owns a fairly large farm, and just over a year ago, he decided he'd be brilliant at running it.
Oh shit!
And that's how the farm, or at least the farm shop, looks like. Nothing too impressive, but man, those are a lot of people wanting to get in there. So we didn't bother queuing up, we just had a walk around the building and got back onto the road. Our last stop took us to Oxford. Unfortunately, we didn't really have a lot of time there, so we just stepped by there for an hour, grabbed something to eat, but it was still a very beautiful city from what we've seen. Maybe I have to get back there someday. So that was our trip to England. Only two nights was a little bit on the short side, definitely, but it was totally worth it, even for the cave alone. We are hoping to come back someday, and then we will definitely also check out the arcade archive on the ground floor. I really hope Neil and Alex can inspire others with their great work. We need more places like these all over the world. And with that, see ya!